हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट, हाउ आर यू? आई होप यू आर ऑल विल बी फाइन। आई एम ऑल्सो फाइन, थैंक यू। लेट्स स्टार्ट टुडे टॉपिक। टुडे इज लेक्चर नंबर 12 ऑफ न्यूक्लियोफिलिक सब्स्टिट्यूशन रिएक्शन, एंड टुडे लेक्चर वी विल बी स्टडी रीअरेंजमेंट इन SN1 रिएक्शन। दिस इज द लास्ट लेक्चर ऑफ SN1 रिएक्शन। टुडे वी विल बी कंप्लीट SN1 रिएक्शन। After that we will show some differences between, some similarities and differences between SN1 and SN2 reaction. We will be compare both of them, what is SN1 and SN2. Yeah, let's start today's topic. Carbocations frequently undergo structural changes called rearrangements. To form more stable carbocation, rearrangement occur in SN1 reaction. It is because to get stability by carbocation. Those carbocations will be undergo SN1 reaction very fastly, that are more stable. Or you can say that those reaction, the step one of the SN1 reaction is very slow reaction. Step one of SN1 reaction is slow reaction. It is the rate determining steps. So it become rapid. The step become faster as the carbocation stability increases. So that's why rearrangement is the factor that increase the stability of carbocation. Let's suppose there is two carbocations. One is, let's suppose CH3CH3H, that is X. One is this carbocation, this compound that change into CH3CH3H plus X negative. So this carbocation, one is this carbocation, and another is this carbocation, CH3CH3CH3X. When a first step of this reaction occur in SN1 reaction, it generate tertiary carbocation plus X negative. While the first case, that is secondary carbocation. In second case, this is tertiary carbocation. Producer, here the tertiary carbocation is, we already know that the tertiary carbocation is more stable carbocation as compared to the secondary carbocation, because here is two alkyl groups, two electron donating group attached, that donate the electron toward the carbocation, that decrease the deficiency of the electron, that decrease the deficiency of electron in on carbocations. But in case of secondary carbocation, here is only two electron donating group attached, that not enough stabilize this carbocation. So that's why those carbocation will be more stable, that have more number of the electron donating group attached. So that's why rearrangement can also help to change the secondary carbocation to tertiary carbocation, to change the primary carbocation to secondary carbocation. How? Let's start. Let's do an example. This is example CH3CH3. This is, here is Br attached. Here is CH3 group attached. This is called 2-bromo-3-methyl. 1, 2, 3, 4. 2-bromo-3-methyl. 2-bromo-3-methyl butane. So when SN1 reaction, when this compound undergo SN1 reaction, all the conditions are SN1 reaction. So it change into, when it is heated, it change into CH3CH3. Here is CH3. It get plus positive charge. But this carbocation is secondary carbocation, because here is two different alkyl groups attached. So this carbocation, and already we know that the secondary carbocation is not enough stable like the tertiary carbocation. So this carbocation, here is rearrangement occurs, a hydride shift occurs. This is called rearrangement is present in two form. It will be either hydride shift form, or it will be either methyl shift form. Only two shifts are present, hydride shift or methyl shift form. Here is hydride shift occurs. Hydride shift will be like this. This is the H bond, that is bonded. So this hydrogen, along with their electron of this carbon, this bond, it will shift toward this carbon. So this carbon get positive charge and it become CH3, CH2, CH3. And this carbocation is tertiary carbocation. So we know that this tertiary carbocation is stable carbocation, the secondary carbocation. That's why rearrangement occur. Rearrangement is also important in SN1 reaction. So this why this mechanism will follow the tertiary carbocation. The intermediate step will be the tertiary carbocation. After that, this structure will be found. So here in this reaction, there is two possibility. When in case here the solvent is like that is methanol, when here is methanol solvent used. So when there is methanol solvent used, here is two different product are possible. One will be OCH3, that is secondary carbocation, or you can say that that is 2-ethoxy, that is ethoxy group. 2-ethoxy-3-methyl-butane, 2-ethoxy-3-methyl-butane. Here is one is methoxy can also be attached on this carbon. So we can say that this is 2-ethoxy-2-methyl, 2-ethoxy-2-methyl-butane. So this is rearranged product. While this product is not rearranged product, but in the solution, in the mixture, the arranged product will be very high in concentration because it is most stable configuration. It is very stable because the carbocation, as the carbocation is the compound ionized in first step, the secondary carbocation directly change into tertiary carbocation because tertiary carbocation is more stable than secondary carbocation. 2-degree carbocation will be shift, will be changed into 3-degree carbocation. Are 2-degree carbocation will be more stable than 3-degree carbocation when there is a resonance present in 2-degree carbocation, because the resonance is also a great factor of stability. Also hyperconjugation is also a great effect of stability. Our hyperconjugation can be also present in where the more the number of methyl group attached or more the number of alpha hydrogen attached. Here in tertiary carbocation, here is 9, here is 8, 3, 3, 6, 2, 8. 8 alpha hydrogen attached, so it become, it have possibility to make 8 hyperconjugation. Where in the case of where is secondary carbocation, here is only possibility of 4, because 4 alpha hydrogen, so it becomes possibility to 4 hyperconjugation. That's why more the hyperconjugation, more will be stability. These all are about the rearrangement in SN1 reaction. Let's do some example on hydride shift and methyl shift. Let's do reaction in reaction on hydride shift. So let's start reaction with steps. In first step, ion molecular ionization gives a carbocation. In first step, ionization occur. Ionization is like that. That is CH3, 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 HBr. In first step, ionization occur, the bromide ion or the leaving group left the system and carbocation produced CH, that is H, CH3, CH3, H plus charge, plus this is bromine ion, this is anion. So these two are produced. Ionization take place in first step. After that, the second step, here the second step will be in SN1 reaction, second step will be the hydride shift to produce stable carbocation, because of hydride shift. Hydride shift will be like that, sir. CH3, C plus H, CH CH3. This hydrogen will be shift towards along with their bonded electrons. It will shift here and this carbon getting positive charge. So this why carbocation will be shift here. It will change into tertiary carbocation. Secondary carbocation will, that is 2-degree carbocation. 2-degree carbocation will change into 3-degree carbocation. It will become CH3 plus charge. So this is tertiary carbocation, this is 3-degree carbocation, and we know that 3-degree carbocation is most stable carbocation. So the product will be, after that the solvent, nucleophile of the solvent will be attack on this carbocation. Here is the shift will be like this. This is CH3 CH3. This is the bond of hydrogen. Yeah, this is the vacant orbital of this hydrogen. Vacant orbital. Here is hydrogen bonded to the system. This is plus charge. This hydrogen shift here, and it will produce the tertiary carbocation. I hope this point will be cleared. Due to lack of space, I am just cleaning the board. You can take screenshot or you can also rewind the video. In step number third, hydride. In step number third, solvent effect. Solvent is a nucleophile. Solvent will be weak nucleophile. Rearranged carbocation, and we know that the rearranged carbocation was the 3-degree carbocation, tertiary carbocation. So the tertiary carbocation was that term. That is CH3. Now here is the methanol, that is ethanol, that is carbocation, that is, this ethanol is a solvent, this solvent attack on this carbocation and produce the product CH3 plus OH CH2 CH3, this product. But this carbon, this oxygen has plus charge. After that, another step is required to produce stable carbocation or stable product. Another, in which deprotonation occur. Deprotonation means the solvent will be abstract proton from the compound. It will be like that. CH3 CH2 CH3 that is O CH2 CH3 that is H plus charge. So here is solvent, there this is ethanol, CH3 CH2 OH, this hydroxyl ion, this lone pair, that will abstract proton from there and it will produce stable compound CH3 CH. This is CH2 CH2 CH3 CH3 OC2H5. This is the stable compound. So these are these hydride sets in SN1 reaction. This is the rearrangement in SN1 reaction. So rearrangement is also very important, very great factor in SN1 process. While in SN2 rearrangement cannot take place, rearrangement is only take place in SN1 reaction, only in SN1 reaction. I hope this point will be cleared. When new pentyl bromide bile in ethanol, CH2, it only produces a rearranged substitution product. It cannot produce CH3, it cannot produce this product. CH3, CH2, it cannot produce this carbocation. Why it cannot produce this carbocation? Because this is very, very unstable carbocations. But this carbocation will be only rearranged product producer. The carbocation will be produced as the atom, as the compound become polarized, directly the methyl shift also occur. So methyl shift will be occur like that. This will be like that. This compound will be like that, and the product, will be like that. That is CH3, and this has plus charge. So that's why only tertiary carbocation will be the rearranged product. This is the rearranged product. So only rearranged product will be formed, will be produced, not the directly product. That is only primary without methyl shift, without rearrange, not rearranged product cannot be possible. Only a rearranged product can be possible, not without rearrangement. Ionization cannot take place in the neopentyl bromide. That is neopentyl bromide. I hope the point will be cleared. Yeah, let's do an example on methyl shift. Yeah, the methyl shift, it can occur in neopentyl bromide, as I tell you here. And neopentyl bromide, the step one will be as this, that is HCH, that is bromine, that is attached on the end carbon, whereas CH3, here in methyl shift occur while bromide ion is leaving, so that only more stable tertiary carbocation is formed. So that's why the product will be, that is methyl shift will be occur, CH3. Hydride shift can be represented from this, while methyl shift can be represented from this, this methyl shift symbol. So methyl shift, here is methyl shift occur. As the methyl shift occur at stable, at produce stable carbocation, CH3, this is very stable carbocation. After that, the solvent attack is a nucleophile, at solvent attack on the carbocation. It is the first step, that is ionization step, also methyl shift. Methyl shift will be occur as the bromide ion or is the leaving group left the group. So in second step and third step, the ethanol or solvent will be attacked. This is the third step, this is the second step in which on carbocation methanol will be attacked if the solvent is methanol on this carbocation, and it produce product, but it will be not a final product because protonation, deprotonation also needed here. OCH3, this oxygen has plus charge. After the third step required for the deprotonation, third step is also required, deprotonation, which will be called deprotonation. And deprotonation, proton will be lost, abstraction of proton will occur. Abstraction of proton, the solvent will again extract the proton from this methoxy group. So it will be like that HCOH CH3, that have plus charge, that is CH3. And here this case of the solvent will abstract proton from this methoxy group, and it give a stable carbocation, it give stable product, that will be very stable product, and that is final product. See, that is OCH3CH3, and the name of the product will be called 1, 2, 3, 4. At 2-methoxy-2-methyl-butane. It is 2-methoxy-2-methyl-butane produced. Instead of when there is first carbocation, when there is, let's suppose this is the carbocation produced on the first carbon. So that's why the nucleophile or the solvent will be attached on the first carbon. That's why the product will be alcohol, not will be ethanol, not will be the alkane. So these are the rearrangement in SN1 reaction. These are about methyl shift as well as anhydride shift. I hope the point will be clear. If you have any confusion, if you have any question, you can also ask me in comment section as well as you can ask me in my personal WhatsApp or Gmail that I put in description box. You can get from there. Okay, thank you. And also please subscribe my channel. It make me feel happy that my students are supporting me. Okay, thank you. Very best of luck, my dear student.